I am here with Austin, Thomas, and Jimmy, three generations of drag racing. And Austin, where are we at right now?
We're at my favorite spot, right here in Pittsboro, Indiana, right around the corner from the race shop, the Mason Inn. It's a great neighborhood bar and a great place to have a cold one after a hard day's work.
Are these guys intense?
Yeah, you better bet.
How intense are they?
Whatever you think is intense, times that by 10. You know, I'm pretty laid back and easy and, you know, happy-go-lucky, but I have that same intensity when I put that helmet on. So mine's a little bit behind the scenes, but you see there's front and forward.
Who's more intense between the two of you?
Jim Prock.
Jim Prock, he's the most intense? Do you believe that? Do you agree with that?
Oh, yeah. I call it whatever focused. Like, people think I'm a little bit of a funny guy and all that stuff, but you're just
What
never,
do you think about that, Thomas?
You're just
you
never going to see it when I'm
Yeah,
racing.
No, he's fine. He just wants to do good, and I do too, so I can't, you know, yeah. You put the work in and you're working hard, that's just part of it.
The joke's always been, if a girl took her top off in the staging lanes, my dad would walk right by.
Why do you run 374?
It was my grandfather's number back when he was driving. He was a driver and a tuner back in the 70s, and I know he's really happy to see it out there flying those colors again.
Tom, what's it like seeing the passion for the sport that you've created?
It's sort of a surprise to me the way they've generated up to the... He was little when he went with me to all the match races. Unbelievable.
Tom obviously created the passion for drag racing in all of you guys. Jimmy, you grew up at the racetrack. Do you have a very first memory at the racetrack?
Oh, I don't know. I can remember coming to Indy here. I was 11 years old, 1977, and it was cool back then. You know, we hung out with all the guys, the Snake, the Mongoose, Blue Max guys, Gary Bergen. And growing up as a kid to be around all that was really cool.
You and Austin, talk to me about your childhood and what were the races like growing up?
Yeah, I mean, we started racing when we were 8 years old, and Mom and Dad, you know, provided us with the tools to do it, and we just had to kind of figure out how to do it without him being there.
Were you always the crew chief?
Yeah, for most of the time, yeah.
And you were always the driver?
Yeah, driving's not my forte. Yeah.
We let Tom try driving for about a year. And
Wait, how did that go?
I gave him my race cars not long after that.
He turned into the crew chief real quick.
Oh, okay, got it. Yeah. So Austin, these last 365 days have been anything but easy for you. Walk me through that.
Yeah, well, coming into this season, I've never had much luck on what my future has looked like. You know, you go from, you know, the outside looking in to getting in arguably the best funny car in the last decade. Not only are you racing for John Force, you're filling in for one of the greatest funny car drivers to ever do it, Robert Hight. You know, Force keeps telling me just hold the fort down for him. And when we do hold a Wally at the end of the day, I know he's smiling and I know he's really proud. And, you know, we'll see where the next 365 days take me.
What would it mean to all of you to win Indy together as a family?
It'd be huge. I mean, it's the biggest drag race of the year. Last year, me and Dad with Robert got really close and had a really good weekend going. And man, I don't know that I've ever felt, you know, so much defeat losing in the semis to Ron Capps there. So to win it would be amazing.
Jimmy Prock, yeah. I have a question for you.
Okay.
Which one is the favorite son?
I don't have a favorite son. I love them both. He's more like me. He's more like
the mailman.
My wife.
On behalf of the entire Prock family, thank you guys for being here with me, and good luck this weekend in Indy.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Let's turn these chairs around and grab a cold one.
Let's do it.